Hello, I'm Julia Verdin.
It's fantastic to have you here at Raindance. What does it mean for you to bring the film here as part of this year's festival?
Well, we shot the film in London, so it's a wonderful place to premiere the film as we're back right where we started. And actually, we shot a lot of the film very close to this area. So I think Raindance is a wonderful film festival. It's one of the few festivals left where you truly see independent films, and it's all about the films and the filmmakers, which is really nice and really refreshing. So this is really a film about people escaping from themselves, escaping from reality in their different ways. And there are two different sets of people in the film. There's the aristocrat group, and then there's the girls who are all in their various different ways escaping from intimacy. And then there's Michael Madsen's character, Bob, and his theatre group of homeless people, and the little boy who's lost his leg. So it's a kind of mishmash of all these different people from different cultures and different walks of life, but we're all with the same issues coming together and through their interaction with each other, kind of finding themselves. So it's a very artsy, esoteric piece. And Michael is really wonderful as Bob. It's a very different role for Michael, as we've normally seen him playing the bad guys. But I've known Michael for a long time. And there's a wonderful soft side to Michael too. And he's a wonderful poet. He's actually written a book of poetry. And really rather good and rather talented. So when we were thinking about who should play Bob, Michael immediately sprung to mind as a perfect choice. And it's actually the third time that I've worked with Michael. We've done two other movies together. So it was nice to have him back doing a different type of role. I think it's about, to me, this film's about, you know, letting go of all your preconceptions and all your fears and blocks and just learning to stay in the moment and live life. And I'm a great proponent of that because, you know, when you're stuck in the past or stuck in memories or stuck worrying about what might happen in the future, you miss out on kind of what is, and you miss out on actually living. And I think what happens with a lot of characters in the film, they're almost kind of ghosts walking through life because they block themselves from reality, and they're all looking for something that they believe is there rather than embracing what is actually there and being present and enjoying it.
And obviously we're here at Raindance enjoying independent cinema. What do you think it gives audiences they don't get from perhaps blockbuster fare?
I think independent cinema is really all about story. And to me, you know, film is a very story-driven medium, and I think that's what's happened in the culture of cinema is that we've got a big disparity between the independent films where budgets are getting pushed down and made smaller and smaller, but there's some wonderful films coming up kind of through this with filmmakers with really original voices. And then you've got the big blockbuster films that are all about special effects and action and chase sequences and green screen, etc. And rather than about story. And to me, being a filmmaker is about being a storyteller and telling a story in the best way possible, using that kind of visual medium to do so.